Hey guys, welcome back to Super Marcel World. So I've just seen The Barge People. I absolutely love this cover art and I thought to myself, if the film is just as good as this lovely cover art is, I'm in for a real treat. The film is very obviously inspired by some of the greatest horror classics and it starts with a very awesome tone setting, retro 80s vibe opening credits, and it immediately piqued my interest. Well, was I in for a real treat or was it a disappointment? I'll let you know in this review. Beware of spoilers. Here we go! The story. Two English sisters and their boyfriends take a fun trip on the English countryside on a barge, but they're unaware of the awaiting dangers. What I like, the monster makeup. For a low budget horror film, I think the monster makeup is pretty good, especially the main monster. In some shots with the right lighting, it really works. But in all honesty, there are some shots in which it doesn't really work. It kinda looks like they did their absolute best on that main monster and the other monsters unfortunately didn't get as much attention. If only those monsters could have gotten the same treatment, or if they would just hit them a little bit more in mysterious lighting, leaving it a bit more to the imagination, it would have ended in a better result. The actors. In a low budget horror film, you usually get actors from the absolute bottom of the barrel, but here luckily this isn't the case. Unfortunately, the characters that they play is a whole different problem. I'll get back to that. Mixed feelings. The gore. There is plenty of blood splattering around, but you never actually see the weapon go in. It's either done out of sight, it cuts away, or it cuts right through the weapon already being in. Most of it is left to your imagination. Now, for a die-hard horror fan waiting to get his fix of gore, this could be a real disappointment. But to be fair, the original Friday the 13th and the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre did the exact same thing. They left most of that up to your imagination. What I don't like. The characters. Like I said, the actors are fine. I just couldn't really care for any of the characters. I wasn't rooting for any of them. As a viewer, you want to root for one of the characters. You want them to make it through and to get out of the trouble that they're in. Here, unfortunately, for me, that didn't happen. Vocal. Now, the monsters speak, and it's really unimpressive. They just finish full sentences. They even laugh. Personally, to me, it would have been scarier if they were mute and more beast-like. Most magical moment. Now, the first time our main four characters get face-to-face with these monsters has to be my favorite part of the movie. It takes place on the boat and, you know, the scene gets really bloody. A negative side note, though, one of the main guys takes out the incoming monster right away, which is really odd to me. Personally, as a director, I would want to show you, the audience, how badass, how strong, and how much of a threat my monster really is. But no, he comes in, the good guy just grabs him, flips him over on the table, and he's taken out in no time. The good guy should get sliced and diced right at the moment the bad guy came in. Showing you, like, okay, this is serious, this is tough. Did you know? In Germany, the film is also known as Mutant River. Overall, The Barge People starts interesting and hopeful with a strong retro-style opening credits, and the film delivers decent moments of madness with lots of blood spraying around. There's some nice camera work, nice lighting, a solid cast, and the film has a pretty good score. Though it lacks a special effects makeup artist, which shows you the weapon of choice actually going in. Instead of just cutting away or cutting to the weapon already being in, I personally, and I think with me, most horror fans would like to see the weapon go in. That's what makes horror horror, right? You're here for the goods, so show us the goods. The film has a fair share of references to classic horror films. One of the monsters even has a Freddy Krueger laugh. You cannot deny it, it's definitely based on Freddy Krueger's laugh. And to me, it's just silly. At one point, he even says, "We enjoy your suffering." Remind you of anyone? And then he finishes it off with a line which took me back directly to the original Evil Dead, where Shelley is dragged out from the fireplace. And the monster here says, "We'll feast on your flesh while you still draw breath." That's classic Evil Dead to me. In all fairness, those were cool lines. I just wish they were mute. Final note, the film lacks a real ending, which kind of sucks. So again, beware spoilers. The monsters capture the final girl and they just sail off in the boat. That's it. Now, I don't mind a negative ending where the bad guys win. Sometimes that's even better. But at least have an ending. So yeah, ending it that way, it didn't really sit well with me. This movie gets a lot of hate online, which isn't really fair in my opinion. Sure, it isn't as great as the classics it's obviously inspired by, but it's not a terrible movie either. Yes, the film does have a few flaws, but overall, I think it's fun. It's good popcorn. Just sit back, don't expect too much, and enjoy. I give the Barge People 6 out of 10 machetes. So yeah, that's it for now, guys. Did you see the Barge People? Let me know below how you feel. We'll talk. If you have the time, hit the like button, maybe subscribe or check out some of my other videos, which you kind of might like, you never know, try them out. And of course, as always, I hope to see you back next time. Bye!